Hello students, welcome for class 5 social. You are here with Mrs. Sheetal Deshpande from Sant Tukaram National Model School, Latur. Today we will continue with Your Right, My Right, Human Rights. In that we need to think about human rights and human rights organizations. Let's see what we are going to learn today. We are going to learn today UNHRC. UNHRC. What is the long form of it? What are the different features of it? That we will see in next PPT. Let's see first about United Nations Human Rights Council. That is UNHRC. The United Nations is an international organization. There are 193 member countries of the UN. It means almost all countries are the member of UN in whole world. Total 193 countries are existed, and proudly we can say all countries are the part of UN. Here you can see the symbol of United Nations. In 2006, the United Nations Human Rights Council was established to protect the human rights of the people around the world. Here you can see the image. All over world people are gathered. They took an assembly and they decided which rights will be the human rights. See here, you can see the Rashtriya Manav Adhikar Ayog symbol. That is what exactly? National Human Rights Commission. Means what? NHRC. The National Human Rights Commission is responsible for protecting the human rights of Indians. It was started in 1993. Each country or culture has its share of problems and human rights in violations. The NHRC in India does various kind of activities. Some of these include keeping a watch on various activities of the government and the people, and nothing when the human rights are violated. Example, the NHRC gets involved in a court cases that include the charges of human rights violation. As you know, government provides the water to us. Government provides the transport facility to us. Government even provides the civil hospitals. But if government would excess charge for water, light, road tax, civil hospitals, then definitely NHRC can take the objection. If we will think about the role of NHRC, we need to think reviewing the laws from time to time to check if they protect and promote the human rights. Example, the NHRC reviews the laws relating to women, children and laborers. Yes, NHRC need to think about women, children and laborers. Let's see the laws related to the women. The first law, that is Dowry Prohibition Act. Yes, because of that only we need to say no to the dowry. If the dowry will come in the form of vehicles, we need to say no to dowry. If the dowry will come in form of cash, we need to say no to the dowry. And the next important law related to the women, that is Maternity Benefit Act. When we will think about the laws related to the children, Child Labor Prohibition Act, Child Marriage Act and Adoption of Child. When we will think about the child labor prohibition, because of that act only, the child labors we cannot find now. The child marriage. Earlier there was a big question related to the child marriage, but now no one has the dare to ask the girl married before the age of 18 and to boy before the age of 21. Related to that only, for adoption also some rules are there. If the parents will fulfill that rules, then only any parent can adopt the child. Laws related to the laborers. Yes, it's also most important. The trade unions, the payment of wages, industrial employment. Here you can see the spreading awareness about human rights. Yes, it's most important. They do this. We can also do this through publications, media and seminars. Publications like newspaper, magazines, Media, we have a different type of medias like Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram, WhatsApp, and seminars which are going to help on national level, international level, even though the district and villages level seminars also most important to play the role for spreading awareness about human rights. Helping other institutions that work in the field of human rights, the NHRC work with institutions such as central government, the state government, or the courts. When we will think about the central government look after for whole country. The state government look after for each states and the courts. As you know, the role of courts is also most important. That is the judiciary system in India. Who help to them? The NHRC help to them. So we cannot deny the importance of NHRC. In this way, today we discuss the human rights given by our constitution as well as the role of NHRC and UNHRC. Next part of it we will see in next period. Thank you very much. Have a nice day ahead.